hands, put your empty hands in mine. And hey, if your wings are broken, please take mine so yours can open too. Cause I'm gonna stand by you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you for your sacrifice.
For your service, bravery, and dedication.
Thank you for all you do for us all over the world.
Superstars of the WWE join entertainment's biggest stars to honor all of you and to say,
welcome to WWE's Tribute to the Troops.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise as JoJo sings our national anthem.
WWE proudly present the 13th annual Tribute to the Troops.
Happy holidays, everybody, and welcome to the most patriotic show of the year. Welcome to the 13th annual WWE Tribute to the Troops. And tonight from Jacksonville, Florida, the three-time Grammy Award-winning, multi-platinum recording artist Trane perform on WWE's Tribute to the Troops.
Actor, comedian, and judge on NBC's America's Got Talent, Howie Mandel, on Tribute to the Troops tonight.
And it wouldn't be Tribute to the Troops without a boot camp match where anything goes. Jack Swagger versus the Bulgarian brute Rusev, and it takes place tonight.
Champion Roman Reigns, the Intercontinental Champion Dean Ambrose, and the Slammy Award-winning Tag Team of the Year, the Usos.
There's a number of Slammy Award winners in there, Michael.
Yeah, Roman Reigns won for Extreme Moment of the Year.
Welcome to Tribute to the Troops. Tonight, we get to put smiles on each and every one of your faces here in attendance, and we get to put smiles on each and every one of those brave men and women that are protecting our freedom all over the world. From me and my family, tonight is about us saying thank you. Thank you for fighting for what we believe in. Thank you for keeping us safe. And thank you for making the United States of America the greatest.
Look who's here. The League of Nations.
Roman, were you about to say that America is the greatest country in the world? Come on! Congratulations to you all, you passed the test. Roman, I'm an admirer of the United States of America. I think it's a grand old country, but I mean, I even think it may be in the top 20, 25 nations in the world. I think that's fair. But to be the greatest nation in the world, not a chance, fella. Tell them, Bert.
Let's take the British, for example. The British have better food, and they clearly have better tea. Oh, come on, I mean, American food is complete rubbish. It's full of salt. It's processed meats. It's smothered in cheese. In fact, everybody in this arena is just one hot dog short of a heart attack. And you know, I've often wondered why I can never find myself a nice piece of roast pork over here. But what I really like is a big portion of spotted dick.
You can't talk like that, guy. This is a family show.
Hey, whoa, whoa, whoa. It's a pudding, all right?
Compared to Mexican TV, American TV is just trash. Everything is about zombies and dragons, lawyers and hackers. Where's your beautiful woman? Where's your football? And I'm talking about real football. Not that American football you people invented to be the number one because nobody else is playing it. Oh, and League of Nations, I don't even want to get me started talking about that stupid country music.
And while we're on the subject, don't get me started about my beautiful home country of Ireland. Back in the home country, we have the greatest food, the greatest corned beef, the greatest women, the greatest castle, and the greatest gingers the world has ever seen.
Stupid, you're forgetting something. You also have the smallest tater tots. Before y'all scare Seamus and his crew away, here, I'll give you an option. How about you and the League of Idiots come on down here and you can put all your theories about America to the test. And me and my family, well, we'll show you what happens when you talk mess about the red, white, and blue.
Here we go, John.
Yes, we do. We're getting started early.
League of Nations squaring off with the Usos and Reigns and Ambrose. Now what? The Fireflies are out.
And you know what that brings?
Not Santa Claus.
No, sir. That's the Wyatt family.
And those aren't reindeers in tow.
They may have eaten a few reindeers.
What an incredible moment in tribute to the troops. Mesmerizing.
We just went from what we thought was going to be a showdown and a fight to the most eerie things you can see anywhere in the world. And that's Bray Wyatt entering an arena.
Need some of those infrared goggles to make out what's going on.
I'm not sure you want to see.
Oh, man! Oh, Lordy! So much for the Cold War! shirt off, tribute to the troops. There are bodies everywhere. Crawling in the aisles and in the ring.
The League of Nations, the Whites, the Dudley Boys.
Don't forget the Usos and Roman and Ambrose. Ryback, Kane. This is out of control.
Look at the size of Braun Strowman down there.
The size of all these guys.
I don't know if the ring's gonna hold them. Hell, let it break. Let them fight.
John, they're gonna need SEAL Team 6 to break this thing up.
Call in the SEALs.
Hi, I'm Carson Daly from The Voice. I want to take a second to shout out all the troops out there, men and women. I'm honored to be a part of the salute to all of you.
Because you have the courage to do what you do, you guys are super amazing, and we really value and respect that.
We thank you so much for what you do.
I want to say a big thank you and cheers to all the service men and women who do their ultimate best fighting for us.
You guys do crazy, gutsy, amazing stuff that protects all of us.
Know that we're thinking about you. We love you.
Thank you for everything that you're doing.
Our hearts and minds are there with you.
Thank you for what you do. We love you. Happy holidays.
Happy holidays.
Happy holidays.
And we're going to hear from celebrities throughout the night here on the 13th annual Tribute to the Troops. But, John, what a way to kick off the show.
I think we can use SEAL Team 6 or the 82nd Airborne to break that up.
And this was just made during the commercial break, a main event for Tribute to the Troops tonight, a 16-man tag team match. Roman Reigns, Dean Ambrose, the Usos, the Dudley Boys, Ryback, and Demon Kane against the Wyatt family and League of Nations.
That is how you kick off Tribute to the Troops, Michael.
Here's the Bulgarian group, Rusev, of course, his fiance, Lana. And ringside is ready for the boot camp match.
Эта страна меня постоянно удивляет, как вы слабы. Вы постоянно хотите помочь миру, но вы только про себя думаете. Услуги pathetic.
Всички вие смахнете американци на нищо не приличате. Кой от кой е по-зле? Няма нито един. Всички сте страхливци, страхливци, страхливци! Нито един няма в тази зала, който да ми се опре на сила и невъзможност. И няма каквото да ме викате, млад мъж!
Thank goodness.
Here comes a real American.
Even though he went to Oklahoma.
Everybody has their faults.
Weighing in at 275 pounds, he is a real American, Jack Swagger!
A lot of Sabbatarians here.
And like I said before, John, it would not be Tribute to the Troops with what has really become a tradition, the boot camp match. And simply put, anything goes. You win via pinfall or submission, but all those toys you see around the ring, they can be brought into play in this match.
Only thing that stops you is your imagination. I love a good boot camp match.
How many times have we had the opportunity to sleep on cots like that in our many visits overseas for Tribute to the Troops through the years?
Stayed in several of Saddam Hussein's palaces that had become CENTCOM.
Wait a minute, you got to stay in palaces?
Absolutely.
Why was I in cots and tents in the middle
of
the desert?
Who you know, Michael.
And Rusev and Swagger getting underway here in the boot camp match. Of course, Jack Swagger has had some issues with Rusev's League of Nations brethren, including Alberto Del Rio.
Jack Swagger, former world heavyweight champion, former All-American out of Oklahoma University.
And we talked a bit about League of Nations, John. What a dominant force they've become.
Yeah, you've seen four incredible guys come together to form one unit. Reminds you almost of the four horsemen.
Patriot lock for Swagger.
This could be over early.
Rusev going to try to make it to the bottom rope, but remember, this will not break the hold. And there's Lana with a covert op. Yeah. Oh. Handing the ammo box to Rusev. Yeah. Oh, man.
Anything you want to do in this match, Michael, you can.
Again. And the Bulgarian Brute, like he needs anything to help him.
That's an old-fashioned Cold War beatdown.
Real American Swagger struggling now as that ammo box to the gut and out of the spine. Again.
What is this going on?
Swagger and Rusev had so many battles over the past couple of years. Some storied battles for the United States Championship. And Rusev goes to the top rope. And now Swagger looking to build momentum.
This is where it gets fun.
Incoming! Oh! Rusev is in deep, deep trouble now.
Rusev, man, just called Natty Knight. Hope that cot's comfy.
Rusev using that foot locker to take out Jack Swagger. Welcome back to Tribute to the Troops here as part of WWE Week on USA. This is a boot camp match between Rusev and Swagger where anything goes, including that, the use of that helmet.
We got our real American Jack Swagger in a lot of trouble here against the Bulgarian Brute Rusev.
Yeah, Rusev has been dominating cover on Swagger.
Come on, Jack.
Kick out at two. Service men and women joining us here tonight in Jacksonville, trying to will Swagger back into this match. It's 300 pounds, John, just trying to crush the skull of Swagger.
Yeah, we couldn't ask for a better representative, though, of real American, though, than Jack Swagger, former All-American at Oklahoma University. Once held more pins in a calendar year than anybody in NCAA history.
Cover. Is it enough? Swagger at two. And Lana, disappointed that Rusev, her fiance, has yet to put Swagger away. That is a very strange relationship, to say the least.
Yeah, it's the old Disney special of Beauty and the Beast.
Yeah, of course.
This isn't going to go over very well.
Rusev's going to get applause for the Bulgarian flag here on Tribute to the Troops. And Swagger valiantly trying to fight back.
It's a boot camp match. Everything's legal. You know, one Tribute to the Troops, I was tried to cancel Christmas in Baghdad, and Santa Claus beat me up.
Yeah, how did that work out?
It didn't work out well for me. Christmas happened.
You probably have the worst record in the history of any superstar that's competed on Tribute to the Troops.
I'm like the worst in generals in Tribute to the Troops. I'm 0-for. They won one game.
Which is odd because you and Ron Simmons are the reason we're actually here tonight.
All I did happened on a 137-degree bus trip in southern Iraq one year.
So it's 137 degrees. Why would you ever want to go back? I understand, though.
I wanted to take you over there just to see you sweat.
Jack Swagger raising Old Glory.
This is the greatest thing we do, Michael. This is greater than WrestleMania, the Madison Square Garden, our tribute to the heroes who protect our country.
And Jack Swagger protecting himself and more. Clothesline after clothesline of Rusev, and the Bulgarian Brute is backpedaling.
This corn-fed Oklahoma boy is taking it to the Bulgarian.
You think the real Americans got the home field advantage?
I would think so.
Swagger! Is it enough? Kick out by Rusev. Man, this has been a physical match. What is Swagger thinking now?
Swagger was going to go for that Patriot Lock, his submission that he's won so many championships with.
Oh, man! On the button, Savant kick caught that Swagger.
Could be it for Jack Swagger.
One, two, no! Swagger stays in it.
A really arrogant cover by Rusev. And it cost him.
And he called the Americans arrogant.
Rusev does.
And Lana.
So do the League of Nations.
This is not going to be good.
Uh-oh.
For Rusev, maybe.
Countered.
Swagger picked the ankle. And Rusev shoulder first into that metal case.
Looks like a foot locker.
He's going to have to go to Foot Locker to get fitted for new shoes after this. Patriot Lock.
Maybe get fitted for a new ankle, and Swagger breaks it off.
Locked in. Is Rusev going to tap to the Patriot Lock? And he does.
Chalk one up for America.
Here is your winner by submission, Jack Swagger.
Lana cannot believe that Rusev tapped out to the real American.
Like a cold bar all over again. We just won again, Michael.
One of the reasons we're here, a gracious host, Governor Rick Scott of Florida and his wife, and here in the front row tonight, cheering on Jack Swagger. And you know, John, WWE has been a huge supporter of our armed forces, including the likes of Batista and Titus O'Neil.
Well, the Munster Festival is a weekend-long event that we hold here at the museum. This year's our 30th year. It's a weekend-long of festivities.
I'm honored to come here with these Navy SEALs. We honor them at the birthplace of where they started training.
It's a special thing for us to be able to come out and honor our veterans, especially the soldiers of the day, soldiers, guys who are still overseas risking their lives.
Titus O'Neil spoke today. When we look for someone who's sort of example of that American dream, if you will.
If you look around, you'll see people from all different backgrounds. This is what life is about to me. When I help the homeless or when I go visit hospitals, people don't look at me just as WWE superstar. They look at me as a human being. That's what I look at each and every one of you as.
He did a great job promoting us, the museum, the SEALs, and the country. He did a great job.
It does not matter who tries to defeat me. I will walk with courage. I will walk with honor. I will walk with passion so that I can continue to say that I am a winner. Hoo-yah!
And the armed forces, of course, need true winners as we celebrate them tonight. What a match coming up later on.
The big guy, Ryback, takes on the former Intercontinental Champion, Kevin Owens. That is tonight.
A tribute to the troops.
Hi, everyone. I'm Joel McHale, or as you may know me, the poor man Stephanie McMahon. As host of Ease the Soup, I like to think of myself as the tip of the spear of everything that could not possibly matter. And that's why I'm not here asking you to honor me. Your viewership that turns into the advertising dollars that pay me will be enough for my sacrifice. Instead, let's honor the brave men and women of our armed forces who provide us with the freedom we enjoy. Please join me in saluting these individuals from the bottom of my heart and the hearts of the WWE universe. Thank you and happy holidays.
Tribute to the Troops is in Jacksonville, Florida. Superstars and Divas visiting Naval Air Station Jacksonville, Naval Station Mayport, and Naval Submarine Base Kings Bay.
Hi, I'm Harrison Ford. I've played my fair share of heroes in the movies, but when it comes to what's going on in the real world, I am truly humbled and gratified by the work you and our armed forces are doing to help protect our freedoms and to keep us safe. Thank you, and happy holidays.
We hope you're enjoying your holiday week with us here tonight on WWE Week on USA with Tribute to the Troops.
There is the world's strongest man.
So
Texas, weighing in at 399 pounds, he is the world's strongest man, Mark Henry.
Florida Governor Rick Scott, his wife Anna, joining tribute to the troops. Huge supporter of the U.S. Armed Forces and a big supporter of WWE as well. One of the reasons our developmental center, the Performance Center, is based in Orlando is because of Governor Rick Scott. There he is, along with his wife, enjoying tribute to the troops tonight.
Tribute to the Troops is presented by Coca-Cola. Make someone happy and share a Coke this holiday season.
I had the opportunity to sit down with Governor Scott in an interview on WWE.com that you can see right now.
It's a great interview on his part.
And his opponent, from Brooksville, Florida, weighing in at 234 pounds, the inspirational Bo Dallas.
Uncle Bo!
Look, Uncle Sam had a great-great-grandchild.
That is a Yankee Doodle Bo.
Yeah, he's a Yankee Doodle Dandy, all right. Mark Henry is just laughing. He cannot believe that Bo Dallas has walked out here in an Uncle Sam outfit.
Hey, Mark Henry was once the world's largest Olympian, proudly representing the United States. Look at this!
That is the Bo. Not the T-Bo, just the Bo.
No, I don't think you want to do that. Mark Henry was having fun, at least at the beginning. If Mark Henry were a piece of military equipment, what would he be?
I think he'd be an M1 Abram. He'd be a tank.
I think he'd be an aircraft carrier because you could land a plane on his back.
The great Bobby Heenan used to say, you can play handball on that man's back.
Or if you really want to date yourself, you could show a movie on it. Uh-oh.
I'm going to go back this way.
Yeah, you better, Bo. Oh, no, Mark Henry, world's strongest slam.
Good night, Bo.
Bo's a Yankee Doodle dandy.
He's a Yankee Doodle dummy.
Here is your winner, Mark Henry.
The governor's loving it.
Bo is not.
Mark Henry looks better as Uncle Sam.
He looks great as Uncle Sam. Now that's a Yankee Doodle dandy.
Let's take another look at this matchup, if you want to call it that. Mark Henry was done playing games when he delivered the world's strongest slam.
There's only 7.5 billion or 8 billion people on the planet. That right there is the strongest.
John, you ready for some music?
You better believe I am. It's Tribute to the Troops.
Coming up next, multi-platinum recording artist, multi-Grammy Award winners, Train performs next on Tribute to the Troops.
Hey, we are the women's national team. Winning the 2015 World Cup was amazing, but it pales in comparison to the fight that so many men and women take each day that enable us to live our dream. We're looked up to as role models, but the real heroes and role models are all of you. We wanted to thank all of you for your tireless service and sacrifice, especially during the holidays. We love you, we support you, and we greatly appreciate all you do here at home and around the world.
Thank you! USA! USA! USA!
Hi, I'm Eva Longoria, and I am honored to be saluting all of our military men and women all over the world who bravely fight to protect our freedoms. Thank you to all of the service men and women who are out there. Happy holidays. Many blessings to you.
Ladies and gentlemen, here to perform their new single, Merry Christmas, Everybody. Please welcome Grammy Award winning band and multi-platinum recording artist, Train.
spirit. Thank you to Train. They'll be back a little bit later on tonight for another performance here on Tribute to the Troops. But the entertainment is not over, because coming up, the actor, comedian, the judge on NBC's America's Got Talent performs on WWE's Tribute to the Troops. Howie Mandel is here tonight. And Feed Me More, the big guy, Ryback, takes on former Intercontinental Champion Kevin Owens. That is coming up next on Tribute to the Troops. Push down.
Holiday greetings are presented by USAA, proudly serving the military community and their families for more than 90 years.
Hi, I'm Del Martins, and I'd like to give a season's greetings to my two little brothers, Nicholas and Sam.
Merry Christmas, happy holidays to all my family in Colorado.
I'm Lieutenant Chris Coleskelly here at HSM 40 in Jacksonville, Florida, and I'd like to wish my family back home in Corpus Christi, Texas, a happy holidays.
From CNET-U Jacksonville, happy holidays!
Spartans of HSM 70, would like to wish you
a Merry Christmas! Wishing you a happy holidays for our operations at Able Station Bayport!
Yeah! Hello, I'm Wesley Snipes, and I'm proud to join the WWE in honoring our troops this holiday season. Thank you for your sacrifice, thank you for your bravery, and thank you for protecting our country. Happy holidays.
We'll hear from celebrities all night long here on Tribute to the Troops, but there's Kevin Owens.
You know, since tonight is all about paying tribute, I would like to pay tribute to the greatest country in the world. And of course, you all know I'm talking about Canada. Yeah, okay. Look, you can boo if you want, but you know it's true. You do. And you know what makes Canada so great? Specifically, is the French part of Canada, which we call the province of Quebec, which is where I am from. Yeah. See, everything in Quebec is better than in America. I mean, everything. The people are nicer. The scenery is nicer. We even have better air quality, which is why French Canadians live a lot longer than the average American, and we also rarely get sick. And when we do get sick, we go to the doctor for free. For free! You know, not only that, but French Canadians are smarter than the average American. Again, you boo, but you know that's true. In fact, most French Canadians speak more than one language. Case in point, moi je peux vous parler en anglais comme je viens de le faire, ou je peux parler en français, puis vous êtes tous trop imbéciles pour comprendre, fait que vous allez juste dire quoi? Quoi? Parce que tout ce qui.
From Quebec, he's from the good old USA, the big guy.
And his opponent, from Las Vegas, weighing in at 291 pounds, Ryback.
Ryback and Kevin Owens on a collision course.
Ryback speaks two languages, English and Neanderthal. However, the Neanderthal part is what Kevin Owens better worry about.
Yeah, Ryback's had quite the rivalry with KO. Remember, Kevin Owens won the Intercontinental Championship from Ryback before Owens lost to Dean Ambrose at TLC. So here we go, one-on-one, Owens versus Ryback. Kevin Owens was not in a good mood Monday night on Raw as part of the Slammy Awards. Neville won for Breakout Star of the Year. Kevin Owens believed he should have won that award.
Well, he should have won it.
He came out, he complained to Neville, he complained about to Dolph Ziggler, who was presenting the award, got into a brawl with Dolph. Then Owens and Ziggler and Dean Ambrose were involved in a triple threat match for the Intercontinental Championship last night here on USA, part of Super SmackDown Live.
Well, Neville has to sneak up on a mirror just to comb his hair. Owens has a legit gripe.
Hey, the WWE Universe voted for Neville to be Breakout Star of the Year. That's all that has to be said about that.
That's why you need Electoral College for it.
Oh, man. Nasty by Kevin Owens.
Well, so was that.
KO has been in a foul mood ever since losing the Intercontinental Championship.
You know, you might not like Kevin Owens' anti-American sentiment, but I really admire the fact how Kevin Owens has bounced back from that loss. You learn more about a person when they lose.
Yeah, I think Kevin Owens, I think he probably likes this time of the year.
Christmas?
Yeah. Resembles old Saint Nick a bit.
Yeah, but can Saint Nick do a moonsault?
Not sure. Owens!
Wow!
A forearm by Owens. And Ryback! Shoulder tackle by the big guy!
Little spine on the pad!
Oh! And there's the meat hook, and Kevin Owens is in trouble. And Ryback is going for the shell shock.
Ryback has got Kevin Owens up before. He's got him again. Kevin Owens smart.
Both men about knocked each other out.
I think Kevin Owens knocked himself off the apron when he hit Ryback so hard.
Who's going to make it to their feet first here?
Ryback, fortunately, has been getting hit in the head where he's most fortified.
Come on. Ryback wants Owens back in the ring. We're at a count of five here.
Kevin Owens may not make it back in.
Count of seven.
Here we go. Wait a minute.
I figured he has no interest.
Speak two languages. Best thing Kevin Owens knows is how to retreat. Give me a break.
How do you say feed me more in French?
How do you say run and hide?
Ask Kevin Owens.
He would know.
Well, Kevin Owens playing the Scrooge this holiday season, but despite KO, in the spirit of the holidays, WWE, Coca-Cola, and the entire military family here in Jacksonville, Florida, well, we wanted to acknowledge, well, a very special military family, one that we believe deserved a once-in-a-lifetime experience this holiday season.
Travis Akers was chosen by his peers and wanted to do something special for his wife. Check this out.
This is so awesome. I think this is so crazy we're here.
I'm Travis Akers, an ensign in the U.S. Navy. I've been deployed 6 times out of the last 12 years. Without the supporting unit that I have back home, I wouldn't be able to do what I do.
He is such a family man, such an amazing father. He's made so many sacrifices, and he's away from his family so often. I'm just really excited to have this day to spend with him.
Today being our 3rd anniversary, I thought what a great opportunity for us to come and spend time together at one of our favorite events, that being WWE.
Start the chants.
We're truly touched to have you here. We really are. To be able to celebrate your anniversary, to share such a special moment, our only plan is to make it even more special. You're the number one guest we have tonight, so anything and everything you can do here, it's all about you.
Can I get in the ring?
This is something he loves so much and is so passionate about. If there's one person on earth that deserves to live this dream, it's him. You are so starstruck, it's amazing.
I just want to say thank you so much. Thank you for your hard work, your service. Thank you so much for sharing, you know, memories and moments and letting me get to know you.
It's an absolute honor sharing a Coke with a hero. So thank you. You be safe out there, and you have a great time tonight.
Thanks, Roman.
Thank you.
Incredible. And John, well, our two special guests are actually here tonight in the front row right behind us at Tribute to the Troops. We want to welcome Travis and Anna Akers ringside. Thank you so much for your service.
And a toast to you and our heroes. And here's wishing you a very happy holiday and a happy anniversary.
John, you're going to want a Coke and a smile for this big 16-man tag team match coming up later on tonight. Reigns, Ambrose, the Usos, the Dudleys, Ryback, and Kane against the Wyatt family and League of Nations all in the same ring tonight.
The actor, comedian, and judge on NBC's America's Got Talent performs on WWE's Tribute to the Troops, Howie Mandel. And that is up next.
Hey guys, Mark Wahlberg here.
Will Ferrell, we want to just say hello to all the men and women in our armed forces. Thank you so much for everything you do.
Thank you guys for your service. Come home soon. Stay safe. Thank you guys. God bless you. Happy holidays.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome actor and comedian Howie Mandel.
Cannot thank you enough, not for the applause, but for your service. But not only the troops that are here, not only the troops that are deployed, but the families of the troops at home, you give the ultimate sacrifice so that we have the ability to do whatever it is that we do. I could not be here without you, so I thank you so much. That is the ultimate service. It really is. And I just want to say thank you and be a small part of this. And I appreciate service. I don't appreciate every service. I appreciate the military. Before I start, I want to tell you one service I don't appreciate, and that is the bathroom attendant. I don't need you. I haven't needed you since I was a baby. You have a kid in kindergarten, he goes to the men's room or the bathroom, nobody's there to help. You have a pre-K, nobody's there to help. As an adult, I just came in from New York, I was at a restaurant, I swear to you, there's a bathroom attendant. What adult in this room has ever gone into a public restaurant and gone, oh my God, isn't there anyone here to help? Has that happened to anybody here? So here's what happened, I swear to you, this is a true story. I walk out of the stall, I walk to the sink, a man put soap on my hand. I didn't ask, he just sprayed soap on my hand, and I washed my hand, and then he gave me a towel, and I dried my hand, and I don't have any money for a tip. What do you tip for that? Like, if he wipes you, it's $20. But what if, just for soap and a towel, what do you tip? I said, I'll take care of you later. I swear to you, this is a true story. I walked back into the restaurant. I gave the waitress my American Express card. I said, put an extra $5 on it. I need a tip. She said, you can put my tip on the card. I said, it's not for you, it's for the bathroom attendant. And this is the line that ruined my whole night, and it's still, I'm reeling about it tonight. She said, sir, we don't have a bathroom attendant. Who was that? Who was that idiot putting crap on my hand? So these are the kind of weird, awkward moments I go through. And I love being here. I'm a huge fan of the WWE. I don't know if people know this about me, but I started as a wrestler. When I was in high school, I really legitimately wrestled. It was the only thing that I could do. I was 89 pounds and 4'10". I brought a picture of me from my yearbook. Look at me. Why are you laughing? Why are you laughing? I even had like a wrestling name. It was Little Girl in a One Piece. That's what I look like. I didn't mean anybody. Take that down, please. Take that down. I don't want to see that anymore. Boy, this is our armed service. You know, we're in election year now. You might end up with a new commander in chief. How do you feel about Trump? I can't tell what that is. But can you imagine? He's got a good shot at this. He's got a good shot at this. And now if he ends up in the White House, that's going to bring a whole new meaning to this phrase, orange is the new black. And I love to see families out here, everybody, the service people and their families. I've done a lot of family programming. You know, I used to do Bobby's World, which was a kids program. Wow. Thank you.
Do you remember when I talked like this? You know
how I started talking like that? When I was 11 years old, I was at a birthday party and I was choking on a piece of cake and I couldn't breathe. And that's the sound that was coming out of my mouth. I was going,
help me! I can't breathe!
What are you laughing at? I was dying. It's not funny. I was Skeeter on the Muppet Babies. And that's, don't clap for that. Skeeter is the same voice as Bobby.
This is Skeeter, this is Bobby.
And I was also Gizmo from Gremlins on the first little fuzzy one that got wet and started those, which isn't that great. It's the same voice too. He goes,
Cuckamagwai.
So this is
Bobby, Skeeter, Gizmo.
I just want to say before I go, what are you saying, sir? What, pardon me? Hang on, I can't hear you. What are you saying?
It's your birthday.
It's your birthday. Okay. Can I ask you something? Do I not look busy? Are you in the service? You're not in the service. It's your birthday, you're not in the service, and you stop the show. I thank everyone here for all your service. This guy, whose birthday it is, no thanks to you. But thank you, happy holiday, stay healthy. Good night.
The one and only Howie Mandel.
Indeed, there is only one, Michael.
Well, coming up next, 8-Diva tag team action. On one side, Charlotte, Becky, Bree, and Alicia. On the other, Paige, Sasha, Tamina, and Naomi. It's next on Tribute to the Troops.
Hi, I'm Joe Manganiello, and as an actor, I've had the opportunity to play heroes in film and television. I've even trained with Navy SEALs to prepare for a role and get into character, but I can't fathom having the strength and resolve possessed by the men and women of America's armed forces who put their lives on the line each and every day to protect our freedom. That's why I'd like to join the WWE Universe tonight in thanking every one of our servicemen and women stationed here in America and around the world for their courage, bravery, and sacrifice. Thank you all. And I hope everybody out there has a safe and happy holiday season.
Happy holidays, everyone, and thank you for joining us in Tribute to the Troops. We're at Naval Air Station Jacksonville, Naval Station Mayport, and Naval Submarine Base Kings Bay, all part of Tribute to the Troops.
Hi, I'm J.J. Abrams, director of Star Wars The Force Awakens. It's my job in telling this next chapter in the Star Wars saga to tell a story of heroes and bravery, and yet nothing on screen compares to the heroism and vigilance and bravery and sacrifice that the people in the United States Armed Forces are making throughout the world. On behalf of everyone at Star Wars The Force Awakens, I thank you for your sacrifice, I thank you for your work and your service. Take care.
Here's someone who would play a great Rey.
You'd play a great C-3PO. Or an R2-D2.
I'd be Han Solo.
Next, the team of Naomi, Tamina, and Sasha Banks. Team Bad.
A Divas tag team match. Team Bad.
I think I'd be a pretty cool Luke Skywalker.
WWE Tribute to the Troops is presented by Coca-Cola. Make someone happy and share a Coke this holiday season.
Introducing their opponents. First, Alicia Fox and Bree, Team Bella.
Alicia Fox, of course, is part of the big Handshake Tour, along with Big Show, R-Truth, Mr. McMahon, went all the way to Afghanistan. been struggling with her conscience, so to speak, over the past few weeks about the way that she's won some matches.
You'd be like me and not have a conscience, then it wouldn't bother you.
And from the Queen City, Charlotte.
And there is Becky's buddy and Divas champion, Charlotte.
Rudolph never looked that good.
You see Charlotte on the Muscle and Fitness Hers magazine?
Absolutely. Well-deserved honor for Charlotte. And of course, congratulations to The Rock, named Man of the Century at Muscle and Fitness. And just had a new baby girl.
Eight Divas tag team matchup. On one side, Becky, Charlotte, Brie, and Alicia. Paige and Team Bad on the other.
You know, you and I, Michael, have been a lot of forward operating bases all over Afghanistan, Iraq. And once the Divas come out, we might as well be part of the wall. We just get forgotten.
Well, John, we're 50-year-old men.
Maybe that's the reason. Maybe that's the reason they took Alicia this time to Afghanistan instead of us.
And Naomi, oh, and Charlotte bounced off the top turnbuckle. Here's Naomi. You know, it's interesting too, Paige, a bit of controversy on the Slammy Awards Monday night. Remember, she thought she had won Diva of the Year. Actually, R-Truth made a mistake, and Nikki Bella was actually Diva of the Year.
It's just an honest mistake.
Nikki recovering from an injury, she'll be back soon. You know, she's gonna have her sights set on the Divas Championship now held by Charlotte. Tag made to Nikki's sister, Brie.
You're certainly right. The Bellas were controlling the Divas division until they have a key injury to Nikki. Like any great team, you lose a key personnel like that, your team suffers. Right now, who's suffering is Naomi.
Wow! Oh, and Tamina just about knocked Brie Bella out of her Santa boots. I want to take another look, John, at the impact by Tamina here. Here's the cover and a kick out. This is why she really is the muscle of Team Bad. Watch this.
This Grinch right here, that'll ruin your Christmas.
Oh!
What an impact. And there's the boss. Cover by Sasha. There's a reason that people, arenas around the world chant, "We want Sasha."
And here's Paige. I thought Paige acted pretty cool, though, when she found out she actually didn't win Diva of the Year. Very inspirational speech by Nikki as well, talking about the entire Divas revolution and how everyone has contributed to things around here. And Paige cover and a kick out. Remember, Paige thought that she was actually the one who brought the Divas Revolution about here in WWE.
Yeah, and the Bellas claim they were as well. And you're right, quite a great acceptance speech by Nikki Bella. And the Divas Revolution worldwide. Serena Williams named SI Sports Person of the Year. We saw earlier the U.S. Women's National Team.
Let's take a look here. Naomi bounced right off the top turnbuckle and allows Brie Bella an opportunity to try to make it to the corner and make a tag. And Tamina trying to warm her up, but she runs into a kick from Brie.
Here comes a self-professed last kicker.
Irish-born Becky Lynch heading up to the top rope, and she is a firecracker, isn't she?
She's taking it to Tamina.
Cover on Tamina. Hook to the leg and breaking things up.
I think it would have been.
Is Naomi. And a shot with a spear. And Paige with a kick right to the face. And now Alicia Fox. Action fast and furious here.
Tamina planted. That could be it. One way to stop it. Straight headbutt to the face. Ball's getting rid of Becky Lynch.
And Sasha.
Uh-oh, backstabber.
Not where you want to be.
And Sasha to the backstabber. Backstabber locked in.
Bodies aren't meant to bend that way.
Tap out. Big victory for Paige and Team Bad here tonight at our 13th annual tribute to the troops. Well, WWE Chairman Mr. McMahon has called this our most important show of the year, and it's become a holiday tradition and the favorite show of all our superstars.
This is a very cool trip, no matter where it is. It's always been a special trip for me.
And I just hope it means as much to men and women in the armed services as it does to me.
There's greener grass on down the road. There's a million places left to go.
And to come meet real heroes, that's a huge honor for us.
Brighter moon and a bigger sky, but I'd rather be right here tonight.
When we come here and they say you guys have cool jobs.
There's something in the air.
Your jobs is a lot cooler than my job.
This for them and work hard every day. We like to give them a day where they can just kick back, relax, and be part of the WWE universe.
No better place than where you stay.
Yeah, I'm the captain now.
So tear up those tomorrow plans.
Thank you, Daddy.
You only get to live one time.
This day couldn't come quick enough.
So let's live it up right here tonight.
Probably had some sleepless nights last night because of the excitement.
What they do and go through, I love giving back to the military.
It makes you feel proud.
Something's got me feeling like I ain't packing up and leaving this time. I'd rather be right here tonight.
Sometimes the roles are reversed. They seem so happy to see us, but at the same time, we're so grateful to see these heroes and look them in the eyes and say thank you. We don't get enough opportunities like that.
The three-time Grammy Award-winning multi-platinum artist perform again on WWE's Tribute to the Troops, and that encore is up next.
It's a holiday tradition, Tribute to the Troops.
Hi, I'm Toby Keith, and I just want to take a moment to say thank you to all the brave men and women serving in our armed forces. When I hear stories of the men and women serving on our front lines or in our homeland, it reminds me of our country's greatness. And I'm grateful for this opportunity with WWE to recognize you and say thank you for your commitment and extraordinary dedication. Wishing all of you and your families a very happy and safe holiday season.
Hi, I'm Neil Patrick Harris. I'm proud to join WWE in honoring our troops this holiday season. The real-life superheroes are the amazing men and women that defend our country and protect our freedom. You are the role models for each and every American and our children of tomorrow. Thank you for your sacrifice. Thank you for your bravery. And thank you for protecting our country. Happy holidays.
Please welcome back to perform their hit song, Drops of Jupiter, Train.
Talks like June.
Thanks so much. Merry Christmas.
And thank you, Tran, for being here tonight as part of Tribute to the Troops, which is presented in part by USAA. USAA would like to thank the military for their service. And, well, we're proud to host USAA tonight, including Sean Rasmussen, the Senior Director of Wealth Management, John Shockley of Military Affairs. Thanks, guys, for being a part. We hope you enjoyed the rest of the show. And thank you for everything you do for the troops.
And the Wyatt family keep on with the League of Nations and take on WWE champ Roman Reigns, Intercontinental champ Dean Ambrose, Uso, Dudley, Ryback, Demon Cage. Incredible 16-man tag team action. It's next.
Hi, I'm Chris Collinsworth from Sunday Night Football. And guys, there's no way we could ever say thank you enough, how much we appreciate every single one of you. Know the sacrifice you make every day, and especially during this holiday season. And from all of us, I want to join WWE and say thank you so much for all you do for all of us.
Come on, Rowan. Look at Dean Ambrose. Taking it to, oh, Eric Rowan with a big clothesline. His matchup just started moments ago. Big 16-man tag team match. On one side, you see the Dudleys and Ryback and Kane and the Usos and Reigns and Ambrose. The Wyatt family of the League of Nations on the other side. And John, we kicked off Tribute to the Troops tonight with this huge brawl that led to this matchup.
Yeah, I'm not sure this ring is going to be big enough to hold all 16 men. So far it is.
Oh, Eric Rowan blasting the Usos. Tag Harper.
Notice Uso's face paint, a little patriotic there. Betsy Ross will be proud.
Betsy Ross.
It's highly appropriate. That's, you can time date that, but that is highly appropriate.
Red, white, blue, Michael, get the spirit.
Oh! Harper's seeing spirits right now. The ghosts of Christmas past, present, and future after that, right? And now the double team by the 2015 Tag Team of the Year. Two straight years the Usos have won that Slammy Award. Tagging Bubba Ray Dudley.
Oh, you didn't see that coming, did you?
Talk about a great tag team. What happened to the most decorated tag team in WWE history?
Current tag team champions, The New Day. They were in a great matchup with the Lucha Dragons last night on Super SmackDown Live here on USA.
Huge back body drop.
Uh-oh! The black sheep.
Tell you what I'd do. I'd bravely tag out if I were Bubba Dudley.
Strowman, a mountain of a man.
We saw J.J. Abrams earlier, the director of Star Wars. I mean, Braun Strowman is bigger than Chewbacca.
You stole that line. I gave you that on Monday night.
Yeah, but I missed it on Monday night.
That's right, I tagged Devon.
No,
there we go.
He's going to tag the Demon. The Demon wants him some of Strowman. Remember what him and his brother, The Undertaker, Brothers of Destruction, did to Strowman at Survivor Series? They put him through the announce table. And there we go. Kane and Strowman.
One guy who could perhaps match up strength against Braun Strowman. That's the Demon Kane.
The legendary Demon. Strowman still on his feet. Not for hope. Oh man, look at this power.
Size of Braun Strowman.
How do you stop that guy, John?
No one has figured out how to yet. And if Demon Kane can't do it, I'm not sure anybody can.
Former WWE World Heavyweight Champion, Sheamus. Man, what a steel cage match he had with Dean Ambrose Monday night on the Slammy Award edition of Raw. And now Alberto Del Rio. And speaking of Raw, John, Monday night in Brooklyn, Alberto Del Rio takes on the returning John Cena. Monday night on Raw.
Last time we saw John Cena was Hell in a Cell at the Staples Center 2 months ago when he lost that U.S. Championship in the U.S. Open Challenge against a surprise returning Alberto Del Rio.
Going to be a great matchup Monday night at the Barclays Center in Brooklyn.
Kane go.
And Kane now taking it to Bray Wyatt. The Demon Kane is standing tall.
Gaines cleaning house.
Regroup time for the Wyatts and League of Nation as this 16-man tag team match continues on Tribute to the Troops. Back on Tribute to the Troops, 16-man tag team action. Uh-oh, rolling pair. Harper's in trouble. Kick out. Man, it's been a physical battle, John.
Yeah, it's what you'd expect. 16 incredible superstars like we have here.
How incredible the Usos been. Two straight years winning the Slammy Award for Tag Team of the Year. Oh, Rowan. And oh, Harper.
Wow. Planted.
And spinning slam. Is it enough to give victory to his team? And a kick out of two.
Hey, if an Uso gets planted like that, you think more Usos will sprout up?
I think two's been enough for the tag team division. And now the double team. And Bray Wyatt. Ooh! What about with the Wyatt family? Cover. And a kick out. It's done to Team ECW as of late.
Yeah, it's not something you'd expect from a team that is used to being extreme and hardcore.
But the Dudleys are still back here wanting more tonight.
I think it's what you expect of the Dudleys. They're not going to break down, not going to back down from a fight.
Rusev, the cover, and he couldn't quite get the shoulders down. Now the big bear hug. Rusev in a boot camp match earlier tonight against the real American Jack Swagger.
Swagger winning the Cold War for America once again against the Bulgarian Brute.
Listen to these great WWE fans here, members of the armed services in attendance tonight. Sheamus tag.
What a team you have here. The League of Nations and the Wyatt family.
Well, Sheamus does have something to be proud of. They have become a very formidable group. Rusev, Barrett, Sheamus, and of course Alberto Del Rio.
Pride of their respective countries.
And Sheamus has not been in a good mood, John, since losing, oh, the WWE World title to Roman Reigns on Raw a couple of weeks ago.
Sheamus is pretty excited in the Sheamus 515 area. It was Roman Reigns who won that title. Sheamus cashed in Money in the Bank.
Uh-oh. Look out. Gonna need some reinforcements here. League of Nations and the Wyatt standing tall. And now it's Luke Harper looking to pray.
Better turn into Rick Grimes pretty quick if he wants to have any chance.
I prefer Daryl.
I like Daryl.
Or Carol. Uh-oh, and now Bubba Ray and Devon and the rest of his team looking to regroup.
This is what Uso needs. He better get to one of his partners. The only one up right now is Dean Ambrose. That's enough.
Tag.
There he is.
The Intercontinental Champion, Dean Ambrose. Look at Dean go.
What the hell was that?
What was that?
I don't think Dean even knows.
He'd make one heck of a Santa Claus, I think.
So what do you do with Christmas?
Slam to Harper. Ambrose gonna go up top. Remember, John, Ambrose tried to do this, deliver this elbow, oh, and he did it well Monday night from the top of a steel cage. And tonight, Rowan breaks things up.
This
madhouse.
This time, Team Roman Reigns meets him.
Uh-oh, Rowan.
Question for you, Michael.
What's that, John?
What's that?
glide path of a fallen sofa. It's effective, just not pretty.
D-Von going a little furniture shopping, got cut short.
Yeah, but the League of Nations not allowing that to happen. Uh-oh, look out, John. Incoming!
What our table do to these guys?
You better watch your hat. Oh, Roman Reigns!
My hat needs hazard pay.
The WWE World Heavyweight Champion. When you say Oos,
I say oh!
Who's so crazy?
That body's everywhere.
Oh, no.
Bam!
Oh, what yes! Oh, and Bray Wyatt looking for Sister Abigail. The Demon Kane not going to allow it to happen. Chokeslam to Bray. Strowman taking out Kane. Superman punch. Double super kick.
The big man's still up.
Big guy knocks Strowman over the top rope. Ambrose and Harper legal. Dirty Deeds.
Goodbye, Walker.
Cover. Big win.
Here are your winners, Roman Reigns, the Usos, Ryback, Kane, the Dudley Boys, and Dean Ambrose.
The WWE World Heavyweight Champion, Roman Reigns. The Intercontinental Champion, Dean Ambrose. Tag Team of the Year, the Usos. The Dudleys and Ryback victorious tonight.
That is what it's all about, Michael. From Afghanistan to Iraq to here in Jacksonville, we've had the privilege of going around the world to tell these men and women who are heroes. You serve your country and we are serving you. Thank you.
And we indeed salute all those at Naval Air Station Jacksonville, Naval Station Mayport, Naval Submarine Base Kings Bay. All the members of not only the Navy, but the Army, the Air Force, the Marines, the Coast Guard, those serving here in the United States and abroad this holiday season. John and I would not have the privilege of sitting here tonight and calling all this great action. And our superstars and divas would not have the privilege of entertaining if it wasn't for you. Happy holidays, everybody. This is our tribute to the troops.